cloud gives us access to virtually limitless computing power. But there's a lot of different kinds of compute services, so we're gonna break them all down for you today so that you can learn which one is right for you.
I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy.
Everything in the cloud can be divided into three major areas: infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service, known affectionately as IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. And so let's start with IaaS. This is the most basic layer of cloud and the one that most people usually start off with. In IaaS, you have a lot of control over the network, storage, and compute services that you set up and how you configure them, but this also means that there's a lot of responsibility that you have to keeping your environment safe, secure, and running exactly the way you want it to be. So let's start with the closest thing to what you had on your physical data centers, and that is Azure Dedicated Hosts. Azure has for you dedicated hosts that are physical servers to run your virtual machines or virtual machine scale sets. More on those in a second. You get all the benefits of using the cloud, like high availability and redundancy baked right in, and some of the other benefits are hardware isolation because it's a physical host that has your machines on it. You get control over the maintenance events that are initiated by Azure, and if your licensing includes software assurance, then you can use the Azure Hybrid Use benefit. Since you already have your Windows and SQL licenses on-premise, you don't pay for them additionally in the cloud. Now, a minute ago, I mentioned virtual machines, and that is the next thing that we'll talk about. An Azure VM gives you flexibility of virtualization without having to buy and maintain those physical servers. And there's lots of ways that you can manage those virtual machines through things like extensions, Azure Automation, Azure DevOps, and you can still save money with the Azure Hybrid Use benefit and also Azure Reserved Instances. This is where you pre-buy the virtual machine and get a big discount. So we've gone from physical to the virtual, but now we're gonna get even smaller with containers. The Azure Container Instance allows you to create and manage Docker-based containers directly in Azure without having to set up or manage VMs. And if you're not familiar with them, containers can do anything from run simple applications and command lines and tasks up to complex jobs and multi-tiered apps. You can manage containers in the cloud as a single unit, just one container doing a job, or you can have them communicate with each other and get even bigger by engaging some of the platform services, which we'll get to in a second. Next, in the IaaS world, we have some dedicated kinds of virtual machines for applications, different from running the Azure SQL service, which is a data service, not compute. The Azure SQL virtual machines are exactly that, virtual machines that already have SQL configured and baked into it. Of course, you could always deploy your own virtual machine and install your own instance of SQL, but this being done for you means that you're saving time in the development and configuration side, as well as additional management features like automated updates, automated backups, high availability, and performance. And specifically around performance, it's the storage configuration that's optimized as part of the setup experience. And then we have SAP. Now, much like SQL, for SAP solutions, you could deploy your own virtual machines and then install SAP yourself. And that is definitely one way to do SAP in the cloud. However, what I wanted to talk about here are something called SAP HANA large instances. These are the most monstrous servers in any cloud, up to 480 compute cores and 24 terabytes of memory. But the HANA large instance has another unique feature, and that it is a physical server that's managed by Microsoft so that you can run your SAP workloads of any size inside Azure and manage them through one experience. PaaS is the next section, and this is where we can extrapolate a lot of that management and focus more on the service. This will reduce the deployment time and manageability while increasing the scale and capability of what it is you're working on. So let's kick off this section with Azure Virtual Machine Scale Sets. This is an orchestration layer for your virtual machines, and that could be from the Azure Marketplace or your own custom images. But in the portal, it appears like a single resource. and you can go as high as 1,000 virtual machines inside a single scale set today, and you can automatically increase or decrease the number of instances at any time, manually or on demand based on some kind of metric or by a schedule. Scale sets provide a high availability for your applications. You can sit them behind a load balancer, and you can centrally manage and configure them, including pushing out your updates. This is the first layer of where we treat our virtual machines less like pets and more like cattle. They're just disposable cogs in the system, and when I don't need a particular VM in a scale set anymore, it just gets deleted. Now, the rest of these platform services are either going to be built on top of VMs, VM scale sets, or containers, and starting with Windows Virtual Desktop. WVD is a virtual desktop infrastructure solution, also known as desktop as a service, and this is what allowed a lot of the world to work from home during the global pandemic. It's a direct computing environment for people to log on to run a full desktop or remote applications. You can run it on Windows Server or Windows 10, including Windows 10 multi-session, and it is generally built on top of Azure Virtual Machines. Although you can technically build it on top of VM scale sets as well, but that's not directly supported by the WVD team. And we've covered already a ton of stuff on WVD on the channel, so go check out my playlist if you want more on this subject. If you've never heard of Kubernetes before, this is a container orchestrator. The PaaS solution here is known as the Azure Kubernetes Service, or AKS. AKS provisions Kubernetes for you as part of a managed service, which will take care of deploying that master management node and the worker nodes for you, as well as health monitoring and maintenance. You just tell it how you want AKS set up, and it does the rest. Your worker agent nodes can be deployed on containers directly or on virtual machine scale sets, and AKS can be set up as a public-facing or private-facing service. Next on the road of PaaS is Azure Service Fabric. This is an application platform for your stateful or stateless microservices, which gives you scale, agility, and reliability. And like the other services in this group, Azure monitors your cluster, handles your automatic updates, and all of the intercommunication issues between the microservices are handled by the Service Fabric. Let's shift gears from the container side of things to the really high performance computing side, and that is the Azure CycleCloud. This is an orchestrator for managing your HPC environments. And CycleCloud can provision your HPC schedulers and automatically size the infrastructure to run those jobs on top of your VM scale sets. And VMware has now moved into the cloud with the Azure VMware Service. AVS was built in partnership with VMware and provides you with private clouds that contain your vSphere clusters built on dedicated bare metal hosts in Azure, and you can deploy anywhere from 3 to 16 nodes per cluster today. AVS comes pre-built with your vCenter, vSAN, vSphere, and NSXT, and you can even migrate your existing VMware workloads into it from on-prem with Azure Migrate, or you could deploy brand new VMs on top of AVS. And sort of like those dedicated hosts we talked about in the beginning, Microsoft will take care of managing that private cloud infrastructure so that you can just focus on deploying your application workloads in your own private clouds. Next, we move on to the Azure App Service. This is an HTTP-based service for hosting your web applications, REST APIs, and mobile backends. And these applications run at scale on Windows and Linux environments. App Services gives you security, load balancing, auto scaling, auto management, as well as integration with DevOps capabilities like continuous deployment from Azure DevOps, GitHub, Docker Hub, and more. And in our final section today, we're gonna dig into the software as a service, or SaaS, applications. This is where we no longer have to worry about any of the infrastructure or even the services that run on top of infrastructure. Now we're talking about pure compute. So I want something done, I put in a little bit of code, the compute happens, I'm done. And because now I'm running a very small thing, a microtransaction, so to speak, the cost in running these services is very low compared to IaaS. And the first thing to talk about are Azure Functions. Functions are a serverless solution that allows you to write your code, not have to maintain any infrastructure, and save on cost. Now, if you need a little more integration with other things, then we can talk about Logic Apps. This solution will help you to schedule, automate, and orchestrate your tasks, business processes, and workflows, whether that's in the cloud, on-prem, or both. And finally, there is Azure Batch. There's no cluster to manage, there's no job scheduler software to install or scale. Instead, you could use the portal, batch APIs, or command line tools to configure and manage and monitor your jobs. And once they're done, you're done. And that covers everything from the most monstrous machines possible down to the smallest bits of code. So whatever you need in the computing world can be done in the cloud. Just find which solution is right for you, and it's easy to deploy and set up. And if you're interested in seeing a dedicated video on any one of these topics, comment down below and let me know. And as always, if you like what you've seen here and you want to see more, that's our latest video at the Azure Academy, as well as this one that the machine learning overlords back at YouTube Central have picked out just for you. Thanks for joining us for today's video, and we will catch you next time. Happy learning.